How's everybody doing? I hope everyone's doing okay. And in today's video, I will be talking about the three things that I wish I knew about before enrolling into a Korean university. So the three things that I will be telling you today are the things that I naturally learn about as I go through university in Korea. So here we go. So number one, Korean universities in general are divided into two semesters. The spring semester and the autumn semester. So usually Korean students, they would enter during the spring semester because that's when their school season usually starts. It's rarely ever the case where you would find a Korean student that goes into autumn semesters. And for international students, you can find students entering in the spring semester, and also there are students that enter during the autumn semester. I would say there are more who enter during the spring semester than the autumn semester. From experience, I would recommend you to go into the spring semester. When I first enrolled, I enrolled into the autumn semester, so that was my first semester for my degree. For the subjects in my major, there are so many subjects that are like continuous subjects, and what I mean by that is like, for example, chemistry 1 and chemistry 2, organic chemistry 1 and organic chemistry 2. There are so many subjects that are 1 and 2, 1 and 2. So in this case, for example, Organic Chemistry 1 and Organic Chemistry 2. So Organic Chemistry 1 would be in spring semester and Organic Chemistry 2 would be in autumn semester. Now, when me and my friend entered the autumn semester, we had to learn starting from the middle of the syllabus and not from the start. And so because of that, we had trouble adjusting to our studies. Not all majors are like this. Not all majors have subject blah 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 1 and subject blah 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 2. It depends on the major. But for majors that have those kind of subjects, try to enroll yourself in the spring semester. If you ever happen to find yourself to have to enroll into the autumn semester, what you can do to prevent taking the blah 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 2 subject first as soon as you enter a degree, you can take a lot of elective subjects. You can avoid those subjects first and you can take elective subjects, or you can take your other major subjects that don't have subject 1 and subject 2. Now the second one. The second one is grading system. So Korean universities have two types of grading system. One is 절대평가 and second one is 상대평가. And in English, that is absolute evaluation and relative evaluation. I'll be using the terms in Korean because I'm more used to the terms in Korean. What 절대평가 is basically the same as the grading system in Malaysia. And that what that means is everyone is graded on their own, on their individual paper. And the grade depends on their individual marks. What the other students in the class got for their exams will not affect your marks for your exams. That is 절대평가. The second grading system that is more common in Korea, used in Korean universities, is 상대평가. It's basically a competition between your classmates for your exam marks. What other people get for their exams, their marks affect your marks. And what that means is you have to be the best out of the best if you want to guarantee yourself an A+ or an A. All the gradings, especially the higher ones, A+, A, A-, B+, have a quota, and not everyone in the class can have an A. Only some can get an A, and the rest will be pushed down the grade. Both advantages and disadvantages to this type of grading system. Now the last thing is an app. All universities in whole of Korea use this app, and that is called the Everytime app. This app is very, very convenient. You have to have this app if you're studying in Korea for your degree or master's or PhD. So what this app does is you can set up your timetable there. You can sell books on there and buy secondhand books because usually, especially science books, are very expensive. So that's really helpful, where you can buy secondhand books to save some money. And usually they have like a 게시판 of information, like club informations or school informations. Students would just ask questions like, hey, where's this building? Where's that? Where's this? Hey, stuff like that. Another important feature on this app is called 강의평가. That translates to class evaluation of professors. Before you sign up for classes before every single semester, you can go to that 강의평가 and you can see every single professor's class or the class of the professor that you want to sign up for, the comments of the students that have taken a class, what's the test like, the assignments like, and all those stuff. So that's really helpful when you plan your timetable. So those are the three things that you should know about Korean universities if you ever plan on enrolling. I hope this video was helpful. If you have any more questions, you can feel free to ask them. I will answer them for you. Don't forget to like and subscribe. And I'll see you guys in the next video. Bye-bye!